Hi students, so now we will discuss a little bit about the principle of design, harmony, the two types, harmony and unity, and harmony with variety. So, what is harmony, first of all? Harmony in a design means all the parts, all the different parts in a composition relate to each other and complement each other. So the harmony makes all the different pieces in a design somehow relate to each other, so that when you look at the final design, it looks harmonious. It looks like there is nothing that really stands out as something totally different. All of the pieces, all of the different parts, the elements are in a way designed and of a type to have something in common, have something in common. This thing creates the harmony in the piece. So nothing is really standing out. Everything is kind of related to each other, which creates a harmonious and united looking design. Now, harmony can be achieved through repetition and rhythm. So when you take in a composition, you already know you have many elements in a composition. So you can achieve harmony by repetition, by repeating elements, or by creating some kind of a rhythm. You already know about rhythm. Go back and check the lecture that we discussed. So by repeating elements in a certain way and using rhythm, or using both together, you can use either this or this, or both, repetition plus rhythm. And this can help you to create a harmonious, a united looking design. So, for example, look at this image here, a picture. All of these flowers, all of it, when you look at it, it looks kind of, there is unity in this piece, in this photo or design or whatever it is, okay? You can see the same flower getting repeated. You have some changes of size, but you have the same flower, you have the same color, you have so many things that unite, that bring the different parts together and make the whole piece look as if it belongs to each other, it's united. Now, the two different types of harmony, unity and variety. So harmony with unity and harmony using variety. So, how united design is, that depends on how well each of the elements that is part of the composition work together with each other, how well they work with each other. So, unity is the harmony produced by all the elements in the design piece. So all the elements work together somehow to produce this final unity. And you can achieve this unity by making clear what relationships between all the visual elements in your design. If you leave even one element out, that it doesn't work with the others, then you destroy the unity of the piece. So you can find unity in a design when you find clear organization and order. And the elements will not be fighting with each other. So it's like everything exists in a peaceful, harmonious unity in this whatever design it is. So nothing is fighting with each other. Nothing is like more important than the other elements. Everything has equal importance or almost equal importance in a way that they like, how shall we say, like dance with each other in a united way. Nothing is weird. Nothing is like standing out among them, okay? Now, you need to be careful. Sometimes too much unity can result in sterile design with lack of personality. When you go over border with making things united in your design, it's beautiful. And sometimes it's totally correct to make it perfect unity. But if you use that all the time or in a wrong place, it can create, as I said, a design that lacks personality. And like a little boring looking maybe, like it doesn't have anything interesting to it, or it's not interesting enough. In most designs, you aim at capturing the viewer's attention. So if I see your design, you want to capture my interest with something. Now, if your design is highly united, perfectly harmonious, it's great, it's going to be beautiful, but maybe it will not be enough to capture my interest. In between all this unity, it is nice to have some variety sometimes, okay? So you need to be careful to balance things out correctly, depending on your design, so that you don't go over border with uniting things, and as a result, making your design lacking personality. Now, we talked about when we include unity, what happens, but what about when we lack unity in a design? That's also bad. Some unity needs to be present in a design. Now, if I'm designing a product, this product, now the elements in it, it's a three-dimensional object. The elements in it have to somehow, they have to be united with each other in a way. Even if I add variety, something changes to it, but they have to have some unity. If it's totally without unity, it will be a problem also. Also, when you have a two-dimensional design, if it lacks unity totally, it will create a confusing design, confusing and cluttered. It will look like all the elements were placed on this whatever design in a random way, without planning, without organization, it will create confusion. And that's the last thing you want in design. Because as we said in the beginning, design is about order, about organizing things, organizing them in a way to convey the message I want correctly. So if there is no harmony, absolutely no harmony in my design, it will create confusion. It will create a messy design, which is not great. So viewers, as a result, will be attracted to what? To the wrong elements, and won't get a clear message. So the message will be distorted. The viewers won't understand your design the way you want them to understand. So, now, in a design in general, you also need to keep in mind that never add elements to it if they are not needed. Like some students just add elements to the design, and when someone asks them, okay, why did you put this here? The student says, oh, no, just like that, I thought it will be nice, or it's beautiful, or just for decoration. This is not correct. You must know in any design, every element you place, why is it placed in this piece? Why did you place it? Why did you place it here, not there? Why did you do it this size, not that size? Why did you choose this color, not that color? Everything must have an explanation. Everything, if somebody asks you, you need to explain, why did you do it in this way? So adding elements for no reason is a no-no in any design. Otherwise, it will also create a cluttered feel. You will destroy the unity maybe. It could create several problems. So before you add any element to any composition, always ask yourself, what will this new element contribute to my design? Will it enhance the message? Will it, what does it do? Okay. So examples here, some small examples of harmony with unity. Like when we look at this, for example, design, now every single line here and shape that we see is different. Like this is big, this is smaller, this is, we have some, the colors are also different. Okay, but when we look at the piece as a whole, we can say there is unity. There is unity. Now, there is also a little bit of variety because of the changes of color, the lines, the shapes change, okay? They're not just repeated, okay? With the same size, the same color. So there is some variety in here, I would say, but it's very, very much united. The harmony is very strong in terms of unity, harmony with unity. It's very strong. So in unity, all the parts of a design or composition must be related by one idea. You know, we can say that this is related by one idea. You can see it clearly. There is nothing going on that, you know, suddenly stands out of the paper. So a unified design has consistency of style. This is a very important word. So in any project, in other classes, if I tell you, use consistency of your style, that means if you, for example, are designing a booklet, let's say a magazine or a booklet or whatever, for a project, and I tell you, your style should be consistent throughout the book. It means that when I open your first page and when I open the fifth page or the 10th page, I can tell that these pages belong to the same book because you repeated some elements, maybe some colors, maybe some the style of the design of the page is the same. So I know that all of these pages belong to this book because you used consistency of style. Okay, so the style has to be consistent. Consistency does not exactly mean the same. Like one page can be a little different than the other page because we have, let's say, different images, different texts included, but there must be some things on the page that indicate this belongs to this book, okay? Now this is about books and booklets and magazines and brochures and this kind of stuff. But if you have only one design piece, okay, that you're doing, a 3D or a 2D, still the consistency of style can consist between the different elements inside the piece. So if I have one poster, I will have many elements on the poster. Now, the consistency of style can also mean that one element is kind of related to another element. So there's some kind of a consistency of the style throughout the whatever design I'm designing. Again here, harmony by unity. Some of these pieces have some variety also in them. Like here, for example, we can see this abstract bird repeated. So repetition is used, okay, clearly. So did we say here what should be? Rhythm and repetition. This helps to create unity. So now we have here repetition, clear repetition. So the bird is repeated. Now the sizes, sometimes you have big one, sometimes small one. Okay, this is some variety. And also if you notice the color changes, between each bird. So there is a small variety, but when you look at it as a one piece, as a one image, okay, as a one illustration, you will not, there is perfect unity in it. Even the way the color is distributed between warm, cool colors, all the shapes, the different birds are consistent of shapes. So the way the shapes and colors and everything is distributed on the page, it is quite like high in harmony and unity. We can say it's very much united, even though this small variety uses. But as an overall piece, we look at it as an overall piece, the design, it is pretty much harmonious. Here, very much harmony. Okay, all the birds are the same sizes, the same theme, you can see this repetition, the same colors, everything. It's harmony with unity. Here also, we have a very harmonious design. The triangles are being repeated all over, the same sizes even used. Some color changes we can see, but when you look at it as one piece, the colors unite perfectly. The choice of colors and the distribution unite perfectly, just like this one. Even though sometimes we have changes in some colors. Here we can see again repetition, okay? Repetition. And even there is some rhythm here, like there is clear rhythm and repetition. So this here, outlines of faces have been repeated many times. Some small changes of sizes we can see, and the repetition here creates a rhythm also. Also, the choice of color helps in the harmony of the entire piece. So we can say this piece is highly harmonious, highly united. Here, for example, again, we have repetition of elements. So this element has been repeated many times. Again, even though the colors are not the same, but the way the colors were distributed on the whole piece, it adds to the harmony. It adds, nothing really stands out as being more important than the rest. And here again, we can see repetition, again, color distribution, everything works towards creating a harmonious looking design. Here more repetition, but we can see also some variety here. So these, let's say, triangular shapes have been repeated. Again, some sizes are changing, colors are changing. So it's harmony with variety also. But when we look overall the piece, it's harmonious. So harmony with unity or harmony with variety, both create harmony. Both create harmony. It's just sometimes I'm using harmony and it's very united. My work is very united. Sometimes I have some variety in it, but both harmony with unity or harmony with variety, they both create harmony, a harmonious looking design. Whether you use both, whether you use one of them, it doesn't matter. Look at this again, harmony with variety. With the color changes, with the some of the shape sizes change, but when you look at it as a whole, it is a harmonious design. This is a harmonious design. Now, whether harmony has been used with some variety or harmony without variety, which is totally unity, it doesn't matter. Variety, as we said, is used to create some interest. There is still no major element that stands out, but it creates a more interesting design. Imagine if all of these were one color, or all of these were the same size. It would be a totally different result for this design. Maybe not as interesting as we can see them now. So harmony is a very nice principle of design to apply in most designs, but the way you apply it, you need to be careful. And again, there are thousands of options depending on what you're designing. So you need to decide And you always need to balance things out so that the result is what you want it to be and to communicate what you want it to communicate. So harmony with variety, we already discussed it. So when some elements just are added to add a little bit, or changed, I would say, to add a little bit of interest. Now, it's also something interesting that, especially in products, in three-dimensional products, sometimes you can even use materials to create harmony. Like, for example, but they must relate to each other somehow, work with each other nicely. For example, if you add, let's say, wood and glass, or if you add metal with something else, do the materials work with each other or not? This also can create, now because you're using different materials, this is variety. But to create the unity, they need to have some relationship with each other, something in common visually, something, the feel of the material, something to relate them with each other. So it really depends what you are designing. Is it two-dimensional, three-dimensional? And you know, even with two-dimensional pieces, sometimes you know, even paper has different types of paper. So this paper, for example, if you touch it, it can be rough a little bit. The other one, smooth. Like if you touch the Fabriano, it's kind of rough, but another paper is very smooth or glossy. So even when you combine this in a design, this can create, okay, it's unity, it's united because they're all papers, but there is some variety in the feel, in the texture, in the, so the important thing is every design should have some unity to be successful in general, so that it doesn't create confusion and looking like random elements put together without order. But how much how much harmony, do you add variety or not? So this is up to the designer, up to the message he wants to convey. Here again, more examples. Now, again, be careful. If you carry variety too far, it can create confusion. Now here, these are nice examples. Here we have the unity here in this piece is created by the same size. So we have shapes, circles. They're all the same size. This creates, so a repetition of the same circle, the same size. This creates unity. Where is the variety here? Different colors are used. Okay, very simple example. So the same element repeated, but with different colors. So here is the variety in the colors. Now here we have again circles, but the sizes are different. So you have big and small circles. So the unity is created how? By using the same color. The variety is created how? By the change of the size. So the way you create the variety can be in several ways. Here we have two ways shown, change of color, change of size, okay? Here again, examples of harmonious designs. We can see always repeating elements, but then we can see some variety. So this is here, rectangular shapes repeated, but the variety is in the change of size. Here, for example, change of color. The same element is repeated, but one is different, for example, in color. Here again, the same image repeated, just the color changes, put some variety in it. But when you look overall on all of them, if you look at this one as a whole, it is perfectly harmonious, even though it has variety in it. This one too, this one as well, all of them. All of them are harmonious designs. Just some of them use perfect unity, some of them use variety in it. So that's the difference. Okay, so this is enough about harmony today. I will see you later for other lectures. Thank you for watching.